my lovely designers. So we are back with another fun learning session for you. In today's tutorial, we're gonna study the problems based on color psychology. We'll be discussing in detail what kind of questions do we have based on color psychology, plus we'll be practically demonstrating on those topics. I'll teach you guys from the starting from what grids are to how to fill colors in those grids. We'll be discussing do's and don'ts. So why to wait? Let's get started. So the problems based on color psychologies are color grid questions. In this kind of questions, you are supposed to fill colors in given grids using your color psychological skills. Grids. What are they? And how many types of grids do we have? Do these grids have different functions? Let's answer all of these questions one by one. So generally, we do have three major types of grids, and we'll be definitely covering all these three types in detail. We'll discuss the functions of each of these grids. Our first type of grid is checkbox grids. These are the most common grids and are generally used to depict season, transformation, emotions, or personality. These grids are perfect for practicing. Our next type of grid is hexagonal grids. They are generally used to express emotions. They can be very time consuming if you're drawing by hand for practicing. So take its printouts for practicing. Our next type of grid are irregular grids. They are used to depict emotions or personality. Rarely questions are asked from this kind of grids. So that was all about types of grids. Now let's see what are the types of grid filling questions. Remember, I'm talking about types of questions, not grids. After analyzing lots of questions, I have personally divided these questions into four major types: emotions depicting, personality depicting, season or nature depicting, and transformation depicting. So our first type of question is emotions depicting questions. I'll be discussing a real question based on this category along with its answer. So questions are framed in this manner. Express the below mentioned emotions through colors: sorrow, happiness, astonishment, and jealousy. As I've already discussed, you will be having either checkbox grids or hexagonal grids. Now you have to choose three most appropriate colors based on color psychology. If you haven't checked the tutorial on color psychology, go check now. The next kind of questions we have is personality depicting questions. I have seen most of the students facing problem in attempting such questions. Let's see how to solve such questions. So here we have a question to depict our personality through colors, and a hexagonal grid is attached. So to attempt such questions, first you need to think of any four personalities of yours. Let's say a student is a creative, sensitive, funny, and bold. Now use your color psychological skills and use those colors while filling your grids. Let us discuss our next kind of question, that is nature depicting questions. This kind of questions are also categorized as season depicting questions. The questions based on these categories are framed in this manner. So progression from one to another only through colors which are to be filled in a series of 10 blocks. A. Dawn to night. B. Spring to autumn. Here's the sample answer for the same. These kind of questions are very similar to transformation grid questions. I'll be properly explaining you how to attempt such questions in our next category. Now, the transformation depicting questions. These transformations can be metamorphosis as well. Let's have an example for the same. Questions are asked in the same way as it was asked in season or nature depicting questions. The only difference is situation. So here it is asked cocoon to butterfly and shiny metallic to rust. The best way to attempt such question is to analyze the situations first. We should picturize the actual scene and then extract colors from these real situations to fill our grids. So, how to fill those grids? Yes, we need to use colors. There is lots of doubt regarding use of colors. Students are confused while choosing colors to fill their grids. Generally, these three colors immediately comes into our mind while filling colors in grids. But guys, we are not allowed to use sketch pens. And crayons don't give us a satisfying output. So the only color left is pencil colors. Yes, you should use pencil colors while attempting these questions. Now here comes the most exciting part. How to fill colors in these grids. I'll be practically demonstrating you the right way to fill colors in these grids. So watch the video till the end. After analyzing your work, I got to know the common mistake that you guys generally do. So I'll be discussing that things too practically. So first, let's start with the common mistakes you guys do while filling colors in grids. I bet after watching these common mistakes which I'll be showing you practically, you won't ever commit mistakes while filling colors in these grids. Mistake number 1, gradation or shading. You are not allowed to do shading or gradation within the grids. Grids should be uniformly colored. There shouldn't be gradation at all. Mistake number 2, incomplete color filling. You are not supposed to leave any space blank while filling colors in grids. Mistake number 3, multicolor in single box. You are supposed to use a single color in single grid. Mistake number 4, hatching or cross hatching. You are not supposed to fill the grid by any kind of hatching techniques. Mistake number 5, pattern filling. You are not supposed to create any kind of pattern within the grids. Mistake number 6, coloring outside the grids. Do not let your colors step outside of the box or grids. Now, what is the right way to fill colors in grids? The very first step to color the grid is to draw outlines around its edges. After drawing outlines, it would be very easy for you to shade within that part. With shade, I didn't mean to render or to give gradation. You have to apply colors evenly and uniformly. Apply same pressure on pencil colors throughout the whole coloring. We should try to use at least 3 to 4 colors to express any emotions. But we shouldn't use more than 4 colors to express any emotions or any of the scenario in grid questions. And always try to use hue of any color. Do not use any other complicated shade of particular color. For example, if you're using color yellow, then don't use beige. You can use red and orange instead. This is the example of appetite emotion depiction. Thank you so much for attending, guys. If you have any doubts, you can just comment below in the comment section. Or you can drop your message on Telegram group.